Hi everyone, and welcome to my fashion video essay. My name is Elisa, and I'm a student of fashion production. Today, we are going to discuss the role of the costume designer and how psychology and fashion shape a character in movies and TV series. Because probably I hate concise titles. Most of the movies I love have three elements in common: good writing behind, a great soundtrack, and amazing costumes. Most of the movies stuck in my head are embellished with beautiful costumes, but a costume designer doesn't create only elegant, stylish costumes for beautiful actresses. As a matter of fact, many costume designers got the most fun creating horrible outfits instead. So, who exactly is a costume designer and why is essential? A costume designer is a person who designs costumes for film, theater, or a TV show. The role of a costume designer is to create characters' outfits, costumes, and balance the scene with texture and colors. The costume designer doesn't work alone, but he had to work alongside the director, lighting designer, hair stylist, makeup artist, and other creative personnel to create the wardrobe she is working on. So a good costume designer doesn't just dress a cast in lavish high-end clothes for the sake of it or for sponsor, nor leave the cast in their own clothes or naked either. A costume designer needs to stick to the era the movie or show it's based on. There is a big rise of historical accurate costume police on YouTube. They need to understand their characters, their journey, to create a personal style that truly describes the essence of a character. And why that, you might ask? You might link the word costume to Freddy Krueger, Batman, or a clown, but can be as well the red Judy Garland shoes or the yellow outfit of Uma Thurman in Kill Bill. So, what it means costume in fashion? Costume often refers to a particular style of clothing worn to portray the wearer as a character or type of character in a film or TV show. So a costume can be even a t-shirt and a pair of jeans and be memorable and iconic. So not just the extraordinary costumes are costumes. But why all of this is important? Because this is one of the reasons why you love a particular movie or an iconic character. A good costume, that doesn't always mean a beautiful costume, adds realism to the character, make them more true, alive. They bring us to the era the character is living. They might inspire us, make us empathize with the character, help us understand changing of time in a movie, and support the direction the character are going in the movie. A costume speaks even when a character isn't talking, and through colors and styles, we can understand a lot of the personality of a character, their intentions, and social status. A very simple example: what color is the Darth Vader costume? I really think cinema was the main hidden inspiration that got me into study fashion design.
And I've actually realized this recently.
So I will show you my personal list of great movie and TV show costumes and the great costume designers behind them to let you understand how they tremendously help the cinema and TV show industry. So let's start with one of my favorite TV show, Buffy the Vampire Slayer. Costume designers all uncredited by Susanna Puisto, Marie Boller, Nicholas Brown, and Cynthia Bergstrom, the only credited with the show. The Witch, or the VVitch, if you prefer. The costumes were crafted by Linda Muir. In the description below, I will put two interviews, one with the costume designer and one with the director. They will make you understand how important costumes were for the production of this movie. You can notice each hand stitch in the garments is tailor-heaven to me. the wonderful Mrs. Maisel, costume designer Donna Zakowska. Donna Zakowska
gives us a different 50s-60s vibe for the era,
showing us more common looks and giving pop and meaning through color palettes. And many seamstresses have given a go to many of Mitch's looks recently. Sleepy Hollow. Sleepy Hollow was my first fashion costumes love movie. The costume designer behind this iconic Tim Burton's movie was the three-time Oscar-winning costume designer Colin Atwood. And I'm sure these costumes are in the memories of many 90s kids. The Umbrella Academy. I follow Christopher Hargadon on Instagram, and God, I love so much the handlers' costumes and all the costumes, actually. Paris, Texas, costume designer Brigitte Burke. It's a movie of 1984, and thanks to Brigitte Burke, I'm on a search for the perfect fuchsia cardigan dress for like a lifetime. Then we can't obviously leave behind Diane Van Strolen and Jean-Paul Gaultier's wonderful work in The Cook, The Thief, The Wife and Her Lover. There is a great example of communication between lights and costume, for example. The costumes look iridescent, magically changing through lights and camera movements. The movie from the same director, Peter Greenaway, has added two notes. Costume designed by Diane Van Strolen are as well wonderful and full of hidden clues and symbolism. How iconic is Gwyneth Paltrow as Margot in The Royal Tenenbaum? Thanks to the work of Karen Patch and the wonderful Wes Anderson eye. Or think about the Grand Budapest Hotel. Marie Antoinette. The Shining. A Clockwork Orange. The Godfather Part 3. The Life Aquatic with Ziv Zissou, The Darjeeling Limited, Barry Lyndon, and even Miami Vice. What they have in common? The four-time Oscar winner for Best Costume Designer, Milena Canonero. She was behind the creation of Alex's iconic costume. She's such a great talent, and she's Italian as me. I would love to give my commentary on each of these great movies' costumes. Let me know if you'd like me to talk more about it. But returning to the costume designer role, we need to add that the costumes need to be thought regarding as well what the character is doing. They sometimes use not the best outfits for some action movie, but a costume designer needs to have in mind if the character has to have a fight or a run in that costume. Another great inspiration in cinema costumes, more than TV ones, is art. Many movies refer directly to certain artworks. Let's think about The Fifth Element, for example. Melancholia. Frida. Barry Lyndon again. Marie Antoinette. Picnic at the Hanging Rock, and many, many more. Another hidden element in costume design language is color. Color is really important in cinema as well as in fashion. And if you look more closely at some movies, you will always spot a certain palette, more evident in some, a bit more light in others. So, the costume designer usually work following and reinforcing the movie's palette through costumes and accessories, another time giving direct messages through colors. Have you ever noticed how often a romantic or lusty scene has a character wearing red? Or who usually wears white in a movie? And the color pink? There is so much we can discuss with the use of colors in costumes and cinema. The choice of a piece of clothing instead of another, the fit and cut of a garment. We will talk more about it in the second part of my video, where we are going to discuss how psychology, fashion and color help to shape a character. And to explain this, I'm going to take into account a character from the Buffy the Vampire Slayer's universe. I will not tell yet which one, so stay tuned and thank you. Bye bye!
Born to portray the wearer, I've noticed lighting, light, oh my god.